See this stuff right here? A lot of people don't know to do something like this on wood subfloors. Because sometimes when you're replacing subfloors, especially in mobile homes when they use that OSB board, and then you try to match up the thickness, and OSB does expand throughout time depending on how long it's been in the home. So what we've done is we try to match the subfloors close to the floor next to the one we're going to be cutting out and replacing. And what we typically do, a lot of people don't do this and you don't see this, when I walk into the rehabbers that are doing subfloor repair, as you can see, this is the plywood, the brand new one that we replaced the floor with. And after it's all said and done, still transition from here to there, there will still be a slight incline or a step down. And what you want to do is you want to put this in the cracks, kind of smooth it out and bring it out like I've done here so that it is equal with the other floor. Especially when you're going to be laying floor down carpet, doesn't matter. But in the bathrooms, we like to lay down lower flooring. And so all of the floor that Steve replaced, as you can see, all the seams, we put this concrete down. It dries in about an hour and a half, and after that we can start installing the floors. So what I've done in lot 643 is I've gone around now that we're done with the subfloor, and I have placed this ready-to-use floor patch compound down. It's almost like a sandy green. And I've come out here by the washer and dryer, by the back door, and I've built the gaps. So this way it's a smooth transition when you're laying down vinyl flooring planking. Maybe wood flooring wouldn't have to worry about it so much. But with the lower flooring, it's very flexible. And if people keep walking over this section at that time, it's going to wear down and cause a crease in the flooring, and then it's going to crack. And then you have to pull it back up and replace it. So to avoid that, you want to make sure that you put this compound where your new floor meets the old floor, especially if it's not flush. And I like to do it anyways, even if it is flush, because there is a tiny gap. And, you know, it just helps with critters getting through, or just any other issues underneath the house that may come up and wet the floor. You know, so I just like something very sealed. And now, talking to you about finishing up the tub, what we decided to do is put some tiling just to outline it. So I caulked it yesterday. And this is just on the outside of the tub. Sealed it up really good. You want to use a kitchen tub tiling caulk that has silicone in it. Make sure it has silicone because that keeps it waterproof. A lot of times I see people use a caulking mat as acrylic. And that washes off and peels off very easily. The steam's in the other room making something. But anyways, that was my little project I wanted to show you today. A little of the details that a lot of people miss. Very, very important. Until next time. Oh, there's my sexy legs. There's my rehab shoes, my rehab shorts.